औज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतान रजीम। बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज़ आवर 10th लेक्चर ऑन एडवांस्ड स्टीरियो केमिस्ट्री। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिटरमाइनिंग ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट कॉन्फ़िगरेशन थ्रू कन्फर्मेशन एनालिसिस। की कंसेप्ट्स ऑफ द लेक्चर आर रोटेशन अबाउट अ सिंगल बॉन्ड, कन्फर्मेशन एनालिसिस ऑफ एल्केन एंड साइक्लो एल्केन्स, कन्फर्मेशन एनालिसिस ऑफ अनसैचुरेटेड एसाइक्लिक कंपाउंड्स, कन्फर्मेशन एनालिसिस ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। वी विल गो थ्रू ऑल दीज कंसेप्ट्स इन दिस लेक्चर। इफ वी लुक एट द स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री एंड कन्फर्मेशन एनालिसिस, स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री द केमिस्ट्री ऑफ स्पेस, एज आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इन माई अर्लियर लेक्चर्स इन माई फर्स्ट लेक्चर। It deals with the spatial arrangement of atoms and groups in the molecules. Stereoisomers have the same structure but have different arrangement of groups or atoms in space. They are said to have different configurations. Different configurations are possible because the covalent bonds commonly found in organic compounds have definite directions. The four covalent bonds of a regular tetrahedral carbon atoms are directed toward the four corners with an angle of 109.28 degree or 109.5 between them. The compounds having the same structure but different configurations are not readily convertible into each other. A compound may have different conformations due to restricted rotation around the single bond or twisting of a ring. In the simple cases, the energy difference between the favored and unfavored conformation is very small, that is about 3 kilocalorie per mole in ethane, and therefore the conformation readily interconverts into each other at room temperature and cannot be isolated. We shall discuss the conformation analysis in greater detail later on. Firstly, let us consider the stereoisomers. Here you can see that this is the carbon. Here four different groups are attached and it shows the tetrahedral
rotation about the single bond
carbon atom. At first, it was believed that the rotation about a single bond is completely free. However, it was found later that there is some restriction in this rotation. Depending on the groups attached to the two carbon atoms joined with a single bond, and some conformations are more favorable than the other, that is, they have lower energy. Let us consider the molecule of ethane. Ethane, let us imagine one methyl group of ethane at rest and the other being rotated around the single bond connecting the two methyl groups. Now we can draw a Newman projection formula. In one eclipsed case, the hydrogen atom attached to one carbon atom are near the hydrogen atom of the other carbon atom and the dihedral angle is equal to zero. In the other staggered case, the hydrogen atoms are farthest apart and the dihedral angle is 60 degree. Various intermediates conformations are also possible. This is the conformations of ethane, a simple molecule in which you can see that this is a carbon and this circle also show a rear carbon. This is the front carbon and this show the rear carbon. When two hydrogens are close to each other, here dihedral angle is zero. Hence, this is the eclipsed conformation. While in case of staggered conformation, the angle has been increased. Dihedral angle has been increased. This is 60 degree. That is why the repulsion between the two hydrogen is minimum. That is why due to this minimum repulsion, it makes the this conformation more stable as compared to eclipsed conformation. Here you can see all the hydrogen are very near to each other. Due to close distance, there is maximum repulsion, and due to this repulsion, it causes to destabilize the structure, destabilize the conformation, and makes the conformation high energy. While in staggered conformation, the distance between the two proton is 60 degree, and due to this greater distance, there is minimum repulsion between the two proton. That is why this staggered conformation is more stable as compared to
now let's see the diagrammatic representation of the energy difference between the different conformations. If the rotation about a single bond was completely free, then the energy of all the conformer would be equal. However, it has been found that the energy of the staggered form is slightly lower by 12.55 kilojoule or 3 kilocalorie per mole than the eclipsed form. The potential energy curve for ethane is as follow. You can see this is the energy and this is the angle of rotation conformation. 60 degree it is has low energy, and at 120 its energy has been increased. Again at 180 energy decreased, becomes stable. 240 energy increases, becomes stable. And 360 again the energy is decreased. Means 60 and 300 degree rotations have the same conformations. From the slides it is clear that if the rotation about a single bond was completely free, then the energy of all of the conformer would be equal. However, it has been found that the energy of the staggered form is slightly lower than the eclipsed form. The potential energy curve for the ethane is described here. Thus, due to the mutual repulsion of hydrogen atoms and other known reasons, the staggered form is more favorable than the eclipsed form. However, the difference in the potential energies of the eclipsed and staggered form is too small to allow the isolation of two conformers. Here it is explained that the difference in the potential energy of the eclipsed and staggered form is too small to allow the isolation of two conformers. Means two conformers can be easily isolated, but the energy difference between the two conformations is very low. Here is another example, ethylene dichloride. There are two positions of minimum energy. One correspond to staggered transite anti conformation and the other to gauche or secure form. The latter conformation has a 4.6 kilojoule more energy than the former. The fully eclipsed cis-side form possesses about 18.83 kilojoule per mole more potential energy than the staggered form. The latter is therefore the preferred conformation, and at low temperature only this form is present. Here this is fully eclipsed high energy, and gauche form has low energy. Again eclipsed high energy, again that is 180 degree, and then it move go up eclipsed form and then gauche form, and then fully eclipsed form has high energy. The energy difference between the two conformations has been shown clearly. here different conformations of possible, because there is free rotation around the single bond, carbon carbon single bond. One rotation, two rotation, three rotations, we got three conformers by rotating about to 360 degree. From 0 to 360 degree, different conformers are obtained. Here it is explained the diagram, and this is staggered form when two similar group are in anti to each other. This is the skew form. Here similar groups have a distance very near. This is again skew form. This is fully eclipsed, this is eclipsed. In eclipsed form, you will see one thing, that two similar atoms are close to each other. Here two hydrogen atoms are close to each other, but in staggered, the two similar groups are away from each other. There's a big difference. Theoretically speaking, there is no free rotation about a single bond. In practice, however, it may occur if the potential energy barrier between various forms is not more than 40 kJ per mole. The term conformation is used to designate different spatial arrangement arising by twisting or rotation of bonds of a given configuration. It takes into account the various internal forces acting in the molecule. This is the structure of cyclohexane. Two strainless forms are possible for cyclohexane, neither of which is planar. They are the boat form and the chair form. The chair form is more stable and has lower energy. The energy barrier between the two forms is about 37.7 to 46 kJ per mole. This value is not large enough to disallow rapid conversion of one form into the other form at room temperature. In the chair form, all the carbon hydrogen bonds and the vicinal carbon atoms are in gauge positions. In the boat form, there are four gauge, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, and 6, 1, and two eclipse interactions, 2, 3, and 5, 6. There is a steric repulsion between the two flagpole hydrogen, like here, this is the flagpole interaction. In boat conformation, flagpole interaction is the main cause of destability. Destabilization is caused by due to flagpole interactions, and that is why this boat form is less stable as compared to the chair form. A twist boat form with 8.7 kJ less energy than the normal form also exists. A twist boat form with 8% less energy than the normal form also exists. There is another conformation of the cyclohexane. The difference in the potential energies between classical chairs and classical boat is 28.9 kJ per mole. At room temperature, the percentage of classical boat is negligible. The population of twisted boat is 1:2 per 1,000. At room temperature, the chair form changes back and forth into conformation. This is known as ring inversion and takes place 10,000 times per second. This is a potential energy in kJ per mole. This is the chair form. This is a reaction coordinate. This is a twist boat. Again, this classical boat. Here, there are the different energy values for different conformations. The axial bonds in one become the equatorial bonds in the other, and vice versa. Therefore, the axial and equatorial bonds cannot be distinguished in proton NMR spectrum. Only one peak singlet at 1.5 ppm is observed at minus 100 degrees Celsius. The two types of bonds can be distinguished from each other. The coupling constant J values are also axial axial 5 to 12 hertz, axial ectorial and ectorial ectorial 2 to 4 hertz. The large groups tend to take ectorial position because here the interaction with the other hydrogen atom is minimum. Here this is the interconversion, one form is converted to another form. This is called flip-flop. Flip-flop means the chair form is converted into other chair form. It occur 1000 times in one second. Means axial becomes ectorial and ectorial become axial. This is the property of cyclohexane. There is another case of monosubstituted cyclohexane. If you look at the structure of chair conformation and then compare with the boat conformation present in a very small amount, and this is 2 into Gauchy interact, 2 into 0.9, 1.8 kJ per mole. Potential energy of methyl cyclohexane as a function of conformation. This is the potential energy difference. This is the equatorial and this is the this is the flexible form. This is the again axial form. Means there's a big difference of energy between the axial and equatorial position of methyl in monosubstituted cyclohexane. This is disubstituted 1,2 dimethyl cyclohexane. This is transform. Enantiomeric excess is 99%, in which you can see that both the methyl are at ectorial positions. Only there is 1% chance of Gauchy interactions, while there are 99% chance of ectorial-ectorial interactions. The difference between ectorial-ectorial and equatorial is 2.7, and other is in which one is axial and other is ectorial. Here axial-ectorial is there is chance to exist 50% at equilibrium, and here again this is axial, this is ectorial, this is axial and this is ectorial. These are the pair of enantiomers, and these are the different conformations of the cyclohexane, of disubstituted cyclohexane. This is 1,3 dimethyl cyclohexane. This is trans, in which one is axial and the other is ectorial. This is resolvable because it has plane of symmetry. Cis form more stable than trans form by 1.8 kJ per mole energy. Cis form has plane of symmetry, while trans form has no plane of symmetry. There is no plane of symmetry in trans form. Conformation of unsaturated rings. Cyclohexene, here the ring is in half chair conformation. The carbon 1, 2, 3 and 6 are in one plane. There is a term pseudo-ectorial. This is pseudo-axial because this is half chair conformation. Half chair conformation. This is trans cyclooctane. It is optically active as it is not superimposable on its mirror image because this is optically active. There is a chiral axis in this molecule. Cyclotetraene, it occurs in tube tub form. The compound undergoes bond fluctuation known as fluxonalism. There is a fluctuation in the bonds. That is why it is non-planar molecule, cyclotetraene. Similarly, cycloheptatetraene exists in boat shaped conformation. Similarly, cyclopropene is very highly strained. It is stable at liquid nitrogen temperature only. It rapidly polymerizes at -80°C. The conformation analysis of unsaturated acyclic compounds. Here is the structure of propylene. The simple molecule propylene can undergo conformational changes by rotation about the single bond. The two conformations are shown below in Newman projection. This is a Newman projection. This is eclipsed form, cis form, and this is staggered bisecting less stable staggered form. Here eclipsed is more stable because here protons are away from each other. Here protons in staggered forms are close. There is a repulsion. This is the conformation analysis of unsaturated acyclic compounds. You can see the by drawing the Newman projection formulas. These are the Newman projection formulas. This is the cis form. This is the staggered form, and cis form is more stable as compared to staggered form. The most stable conformation is that in which the double bond is eclipsed with one of the carbon hydrogen bond of methyl group. The barrier to rotation in propylene is nearly 2 kilocalorie per mole, 8.4 kilojoule per mole. The proton-proton eclipsing in the bisecting conformation only account for about 1 kilocalorie per mole, 4.2 kilojoule per mole. That is one half of the total barrier. There seems to be an additional destabilization of about same magnitude due to unfavorable interactions of the other two CH bonds with the carbon double bond, carbon pi orbital in this conformation. This is one butene. There are two possible eclipsed conformations. One is with carbon double bond carbon eclipsed with methyl, and the other gauge with carbon double bond CH2 eclipsed with hydrogen. Here this is the cis form, this is the gauge form. R can be H, R can be H, R can be methyl. The difference in enthalpy of cis and gauge form is smaller, about 0.53 kilocalorie per mole. In substitute propylenes of the formula RCH2, CH double bond CH2, where R is small, electronegative substituents, as for example fluoro, methoxy, cyano, the cis conformer clearly predominates. The barrier of to interconversion of one butene conformer is 1.74 kilocalorie per mole above the most stable gauge form. The conformation at the energy maximum is bisecting, and its conformation energy agrees quite well with that of bisecting conformation in propylene, about 1.98 kilocalorie per mole or 8.3 kilojoule per mole. This is the structure of one butene, substituted butene. Then there is a chirality due to restricted rotation. It may be emphasized here once again that the presence of an asymmetric carbon atom is not necessary for a compound to show optical activity. As I have discussed in my earlier lectures, that it is not necessary condition that if there is chiral carbon, then the compound is optically active. There are other factors, like rather the whole molecule should be asymmetric and not superimposable on its mirror image. An excellent example of optical active compound devoid of any asymmetric carbon atom is ortho substituted biphenyl. If the biphenyl compound contains 3, in some cases even 2, large groups at ortho position, the rotation about the single bond joining the two phenyl groups is hindered. The plane of the two groups are at 90 degree to each other, and the molecule becomes asymmetric and therefore optically active. This is biphenyl. This is hindered because this and this, these two are mirror image, while non-superimposing mirror image. While there is restricted rotation, and this is chiral plane in the molecule, which makes the molecule chiral. Furthermore, you can see in this molecule there is no any such carbon which contain four different groups attached. This is the plane molecule, but due to chiral plane, the compounds become optically active. For a biphenyl compound to show optical activity, it is necessary that neither ring must have a planar symmetry, is not resolvable, whereas 2 is. This is has planar symmetry, while this group don't have planar symmetry. That is why this is not, whereas this is resolvable, this is not resolvable. The substituent at ortho position must have large size. Diphenic acid is optically inactive because the two rings can become coplanar, and then it will have a plane or center of symmetry. This is the plane of symmetry. This is diphenic acid, center of symmetry. Then there is racemization. The optically active biphenyl compounds can be racemized through heating, which increases the which increases the amplitude of vibrations of substituent group in 2-2-60- position, and also the amplitude of vibration of the two benzene ring with respect to each other. This allows the substituents to slip by one another. Thus, the two rings become planar, and the final product may contain equal amounts of plus and minus forms. Configuration of optically active biphenyls. Since optically active biphenyls do not contain a chiral carbon or an ether chiral atom, there are special rules for assigning R and S configuration to them. The substituted biphenyls are viewed in a conformation where the two rings are perpendicular along the axis of bonds joining the rings. The biphenyl with four ortho substituents at 2-6-2-6, the four ortho substituents are projected on a plane at right angle to the bond joining the rings. For the sake of uniformity, front benzene ring is placed horizontally and the rear ring vertically. As in 1A, this is however not essential. You can see here, you will look and you will draw. Now the structure is written in the form of 1B. Proximity rule: the near groups precedes far groups. This rule takes precedence over sequence rule. Thus, in the molecule structure shown in 1B, the horizontal near groups take precedence over the vertical far groups. Out of two groups in the near horizontal ring, nitro group has priority 1 because of sequence rule, the carboxylic acid priority 2. Similarly, out of the two groups of the near vertical rings into the nitro groups has a precedence priority 3 over the carboxylic acid, which has lowest priority. Now if we go from priority 1 through priority 2 to priority 3, we are making a clockwise circle. Therefore, the compound has a R configuration like this. This is got 1, this 2, 4 and 3 and 4. This is clockwise rectus. Then the configuration of this biphenyl compound is R. This compound 3, again the carboxyl group at para C4 and C4 dash position are not taken into consideration because they are along the axis. Here we will not take these carboxylic acid, we will take these hydrogen and these bromo groups. This got 1 priority and this got 2 priority, and this again 3 and 4 priority. Again the rule is at 1, 2, 3 and 4. Again, this is S sinister, anti-clockwise. Biphenyl with meta substituents. In this case it is no more impartial which ring is to be placed in front. According to proximity rule, the near groups precedes far groups. It follows that the ring that has substituents of the main axis of the molecule nearest to the external observer is to be placed in front. Thus, whenever there is a three substituent, the ring in which it occurs is placed in front, and 3-5 substituents rather than 2-6 substituents determine the sequence. This is compound number 4. Here you will see that when we see this is got priority 1 and this priority 2, again this priority 3 and this is 4, and we neglect these nitro groups. Here you will see that 1, 2, 3 and this is clockwise direction, and the configuration would be R for this compound. Then there is conformation analysis of carbohydrates. This is glucose. It is a hexose. It is an aldose. It has a deconfiguration. Same configuration at the furthermost steogenic center, C5, as D-glyceraldehyde. This is glucose. This is glyceraldehyde. Aldehyde reaction of glucose, Stalin's reactions on warming with ammonical silver nitrate solution. Silver ends are reduced to metallic silver, giving a silver mirror. Failing reactions, failing solution is reduced to yellow to reddish copper oxide. Nylander reactions on warming with alkaline bismuth salt solution, black metallic bismuth is precipitated. Ossazone reaction on warming with phenylhydrazine, we get phenylhydrazone. The aldehyde group may be reduced by borohydride to primary alcohol group giving sorbitol. The aldehyde group may be oxidized by mild oxidizing agent like bromine water or dilute nitric acid to SD group yielding glucuronic acid. It forms cyanohydrin with HCN enzymes with hydroxyl amine. The IR NMR spectra of glucose do not show any peaks due to aldehyde. It is a masked aldehyde group. Here is the spectral difference of a glucose. The molecular weight is 180 and the spectra is taken in the diluted solvent. These are the different spectras. IR spectra of this is the proton mass spectra of the glucose, which show different peaks in different regions. Then there are hemiacetal formation in the glucose. When aldehyde react with alcohol, hemiacetal is formed. This is acetal and this is hemiacetal. The difference between the two is only that here carbon attached with OH and OR, here carbon OR and OR, both are OR acetal, one OR and one OH is hemiacetal. Glucose is a hemiacetal formed by the reaction of one of the hydroxyl group with aldehyde in the molecule. Here lone pair of oxygen attack on this carbonyl and beta D glucose is formed. This is alpha D glucose. This is pyranose form. This is furanose form of glucose. Mutual rotations means alpha D glucopyranose open chain less than 0.1%, beta D glucopyranose, alpha D 19 degree. Specific rotation, the equilibrium mixture is for D is 52.5 degree. Alpha glucose can be obtained by crystallizing glucose from cold aqueous solution. Beta glucose can be obtained by crystallizing glucose from hot saturated aqueous solution. The new steogenic center generated by hemiacetal ring closure is called anomeric center, generally at carbon number 1. Carbon 1 is the anomeric. If the hydroxyl group bound to this anomeric center point in the same direction sees as the most distant steogenic center C5 in the glucose, this anomer is called alpha anomer. When they are pointing in opposite direction, it is beta anomer. This is alpha anomer. This is beta. This is alpha D glucose. This is beta D. The difference between the orientation of this OH group. This alpha D glucose. This is Walden inversion. Walden inversion at the anomeric carbon result in the formation of this cyclic structure. This is hemiacetal formation of alpha D glucose. This is beta D glucopyranose. This is Mills projection. Mills are the scientist who discovered this structure. Dot line show behind the plane and bold line show above the plane. This is the Haworth projection of glucose molecule. This is beta D glucopyranose. Dear students, here are some questions you have to give answer. नंबर वन इज द मॉलिक्यूल शोन बिलो इज कायरल ए कायरल, इज द मॉलिक्यूल शोन बिलो इज कायरल ए कायरल, इज द मॉलिक्यूल शोन बिलो इज कायरल ए कायरल, इज द मॉलिक्यूल शोन बिलो इज कायरल ए कायरल, देन यू हैव इज द मॉलिक्यूल शोन बिलो कायरल ए कायरल, दीज आर डिफरेंट. यू हैव टू गिव द नेम एंड यू हैव टू गिव असाइन द प्रायोरिटी, यू हैव गिव गिव द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन स्टीरियोसोमर डेस्टियोसोमर एंड आल्सो यू हैव टू डिटरमाइन द कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड्स. Label each asymmetric carbon in the compound below as RR as configuration. This was all about the conformation of compounds, and you have to answer these questions. And if you have any question, you can ask me, and I will discuss with you. And now we will discuss very small material, because a huge material has been collected in your Google classrooms. I wish you have to absorb some knowledge of stereochemistry. Inshallah, we will study on daily basis a small portion of each topic so that you can absorb easily. If you have questions, you can ask me. Allah Hafiz.